Hello, test 1 2 3. Testing 1 2 1 2 1 2. Testing 1 2 3 4 5. 1 2 3. Testing 1 2 3. 1 2 3. Test 1 2 3 4 5. 8-channel audio coming your way. Thank you.
Michael also hosts his own comedy tour. Michael Yo presents Hot Flash Comedy, which just recently visited Fort Lauderdale. So let's give it up for Michael. Michael Yo. It's time for the introduction.
Record, Alejandro. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the International Polo Club of Palm Beach and today's coverage of the Piaget-USPA Gold Cup. This is a quarterfinal match. The loser goes home. The winner advances to a chance to compete in the semifinals during the week. And then, of course, we'll be here to bring you the coverage next Sunday of the finals of this USPA Gold Cup. Two great teams here today. Alegria, number one, is Julian Mannix. Playing at number two is his older brother, Fred Mannix. Mariano Aguirre, a veteran here. He's won so many Gold Cups, it's unbelievable. We'll talk a lot about him during the game. He'll be the playmaker of this game. He'll touch the ball more than anybody throughout the course of the match. Tomas Garcia del Rio will be at number four. He'll play at the back. Also, he's been very critical in the way this team has advanced through these first two 26-goal tournaments. Valiente 2. There are two Valiente teams. Today, Valiente 2 is led by young Robert Jernavis, who is a college junior. He'll finish his college career in Europe next year. Alejo Taranco is playing at number 2. Pilon Sterling at 10 goals is number 3. And, of course, Adolfo Cambiasso will be at the back at number 4. He definitely will be a major playmaker in any decision about how they're going to play out this game here today. We'll start on the flat. Both of these are two 26-goal teams. And I'd like to welcome to our announce booth today Robert Orthwine, who will be doing the color commentary and helping us work our way through some of the penalty shots and giving us some great information on the real inside workings of polo. Robert, welcome.
Ron, thanks for having me. It's going to be a real great game today. Fortunate out here to have Adolfo Cambiasso, one of the best players of all time. And like you said, Mariano Aguirre playing for the Alegria team. Great captain, strong veteran player. Should be an excellent match. Really excited to see it here today.
All right, the players have lined up at midfield. If you have never seen polo before, we line up at the middle of the field. It's 150 yards in each direction toward the goal. The ball is in play, and we are underway. Scramble for the ball. Mariano Aguirre has it right out of the throw-in. Aguirre holding on. He has nobody in red up front to pass to. Alegria will be the red team. Right now they're going to the south end where the scoreboard is located. Matt Dash for the ball over by the boards. Freddie Mannix has it there. Adolfo challenges him on the gray horse, overrides the play. Now it's left behind by the boards. And here goes Adolfo. Cambiasso on a breakaway on the gray. Here's Adolfo, ready to pick it up in midfield. Easy slider, working at about 50 yards down inside, about 80 yards out. There's nobody on him as he puts the brakes on. Now he turns the direction, coming to the goalpost. Adolfo out in front, tapping, looks up, wants to check where the posts are. There's the hit to goal, and he's got one. Adolfo Cambiasso within the first minute of the play. Robert, we're going to see a lot of this guy today.
That's for sure. It was a great goal there. You saw Agria down at the far end kind of trying to slow it down, but can't do that with a Dolph. It was too quick. He'll pick it up, get into the open field, take it straight to goal just like he did. That's why he's 10 goals, Ron.
Yep, and a lot of people would argue with you that he would be 11 if he was allowed to be.
Maybe 12. He's strong.
Yep, you're right. All right, here we are back at the throw-in. Now, we have changed directions. You notice the yellow team just scored going to your left. Now we'll switch, and they'll go to the right. That's one of those antiquated rules at polo that somehow it's never gotten changed because they try to do that based on the condition of the field and the sun advantage. But the ball's in play, and we're underway. And guess what? It's Adolfo again, loose, out in front. Adolfo out on the left-hand side, little flip shot. He's overridden the play right there. Backhander cleared out by Alegria as it goes into that southeast corner. Back shot off of the near side. There's Adolfo taking an angled neck shot to go. And it goes wide and out of play. No good. Tough break there. They're going to have to really watch this guy. He's loose too early in the game for this kind of thing to happen.
You really got to have somebody or maybe even two guys just really stick on Adolfo. I mean, he's so quick. He can do everything. He doesn't miss. You know, they got a break there that he hit it wide, but that's not going to happen all game. I'll think those.
Yeah, he could end up being the leading scorer of the match here. That's happened so frequently, whether it's a 20-goal level or the 40-goal level. Knocking for Alegria as they pick it up on the far boards. Alegria with a nice pop shot downfield. That'll bounce and roll all the way to midfield. Pelon picks it up. Pelon is Adolfo's teammate in Argentina. These guys won that tournament last fall. They are spectacular together and a huge threat against this red team here today. There's Aguirre stopping that pass. Now he kind of cuts a slice back the other way and it hops out of bounds and goes out of play. So the umpire will call everybody together right where the ball went out of play. And from there, we'll put it back into play as the clock continues to tick down. 1-0 in favor of yellow here. The Valiente 2 team. Throw in. Gets kicked by the pony. Adolfo in the quick gray jumps on that as he works it on the boards. Adolfo going to the corner. Adolfo now making a hard left-hand turn, coming to goal with it. Adolfo stays with it. There's the shot. And no indication from the flagger. I'm not sure what happened down there. Could you see that, Robert?
I think it went just a little wide. He kind of overshot it, went right across the goal mouth. You see Adolfo there. He's going very aggressively forward. It's because he's able to have a guy like Pelon Sterling, who's also 10 goals, actually the newest 10-goaler here in the United States. And he's able to sort of cover Adolfo when Adolfo wants to make a run.
Here's the replay. Take a look at this.
Right on the end line, looked like it just went right across the goal mouth and lot on the other side. That doesn't happen. They're just getting their bearings straight here in the first chucker play.
All right, so the ball goes back over to red. We're down to 4:15 left in the first period. Regulation play will be 6 chuckers. We're just in the early stages of the first one here. Important match for both teams because Alegria will be up here in the stands with us next Sunday if they can't win this one today. Off the boards, it's Aguirre. There's a hook on Mannix. Aguirre asking the player to leave it, but Mannix already stroked it on downfield. Picking it up, 60 yards out. Del Rio's on it. Del Rio switches to the near side, and he's got the goal. Great play there, Robert. That was outstanding. Mariano wanted that ball back there about 200 yards away, but it really played out in favor of Red. That was really awesome here. Here's the replay.
You really got to credit Freddie Mannix there. Great pass by Freddie, able to evade the hook. Get a quick pass off to Tomas Garcia del Rio. Rio takes it all the way in and is able to have a nice finish here on the near side, taking out the man and everything. Real nice team play there by Alegria.
That's what they're going to have to do all afternoon long here. All 4 players participating in the great game. They're all rated, so there's a lot of balance on this team more than anything else. So that might make a difference in their favor. Umpire's got everybody lined up. He wants 4 red on the left and 4 yellow on the right. And he won't give them the ball back until they line up and then they all sort of charge him, so he'll want some room there to get it bowled down the alleyway. But at this level, there's seldom an alleyway. It's more like a traffic congestion.
Exactly. It's definitely like an offensive line, defensive line battle here. It's really in the trenches on these throw-ins.
All right, Robert, here we go. There's the throw-in. Nice pickoff on the near side. Valiente, too, coming with the ball. Quick hook on Alejo. Quick turnaround. Aguirre picks it up. Mariano swats it on downfield. In hot pursuit is Pelon Sterling. Mariano's coming wide to the line to get room to ride in there to finish it off. There's the cut shot on the angle. And it's cut out right at the last minute, right in front of that goal mouth, and a beautiful defensive play for yellow. Adolfo, a little pop shot as the mallets clash, and the ball kicks out to the side. Aguirre, back shot, lays a beautiful pass right down in front. There's the cut shot, up in the air, and in. Wow, what a play. Two great goals for Red back-to-back. Robert, they were persistent all the way through there. They never let it up on that one.
Great effort. You saw Freddie Mannix. I don't know if you saw it here. He's taking Adolfo on the back of the play, making sure he didn't get in there. He's got Freddie Mannix. He's 6 goals here in the United States, but he's 8 in Argentina. Very strong player, one of the top players. He's actually a Canadian guy, and he's very, very strong, very, very quick, and he's able to stay disciplined with Adolfo. Could see a lot of action.
All right, here's the battle by the boards now. Pelon picks it up on the far side of the field, right in front of the lodge. Now the pony kicks it away. Jernov is trying to jockey in there to push that guy out of the play. Nope, it's going to get turned around. Cut shot, back the other way by Fred Mannix. Now there's a center shot, still at the south end of the field. Adolfo checks down on the horse now. Kind of tries to fake the player out as he hits it down into the corner. He'll run out of real estate down there if he can't get turned around. Adolfo still on it. Working along the back line. Still working it. Heavy, heavy traffic now. The more the ball slows down, the more the players try to collect around it. There's the shot. And it's wide to the outside. No good. Tough break there. Boy, he must have hit that thing 15 times before he finally went to goal with it. There's the replay right there.
What you're going to see a lot in this game today is you're going to see a lot of sort of individual play here on the Valiente. On the Valiente side, you got Adolfo, who's one of the best players of all time. And Salagria team is going to counter with a little more team play. You see Freddie Mannix working quick passes to Rio, his brother Julian, and Mariano. They set it up and they try and get the speed through the passing, whereas Valiente is just going to get the speed from the athleticism of Adolfo. It's incredible.
All right, 2-1, Alegria. And I think we had a whistle down in the end zone, and they're pretty strict recently with the technicals. You really have to play it straight out there these days.
You really got to credit the refs out here. You see Dale Schwetz, one of the best refs in USPA, and they really keep the players in line, and it's what needs to happen, especially early in the game. You don't want it getting out of hand, and it's very, very intense out there. These guys go at high speeds, big bumps, big animals, a lot of collisions, so got to keep it safe, got to keep it clean, talking to a minimum.
All right, and we'll have a penalty shot now in midfield for Red. That's the Alegria team. Del Rio, first shot. That's going to get some legs on it. It's going to roll down about 60 yards out. They're battling for the possession right there, and there goes the whistle to stop the play once again. Two guys kind of came together over top of that ball. That was a little tough there because the temptation's there, and you want to make the play, but the ball kind of rolled underneath everybody's horse.
Let's see what the referees call here. They're talking it over, but it looks like might have been a 2-1. You got to give Freddie Mannix a lot of credit here. He did a lot of work here, working to get that leg and get around Adolfo so he could have some position to come back on that ball, but he might have been working a little too hard and pushed Adolfo across the line that Adolfo's teammate Pelon had. But see what the refs call.
Well, Freddie Mannix teed it up there at the penalty line, so he's pretty convinced. But I guess he was just trying to fake out the umpires at that point. Nobody was watching.
Sometimes that works, and sometimes it doesn't. That was the time it didn't, so looks like it's going to be back to 50-50. Throw in. Here we go.
Out the back door. It goes right to the stick of Adolfo. Adolfo's on it. Aguirre's in hot pursuit. Adolfo puts it on the boards. He'll wait for it to carry him off of there. Now he leaves it for Pelon, and he'll drop in behind him, and Pelon gives a little push and a good fake there as they got Red empty-handed. Adolfo, a 100-yarder, still rolling toward goal, down around 60 yards out. There's the back shot by Mannix, and he wallops that thing back out of there. A beautiful power backhander. Adolfo faking the backhand. Mannix on the pickup, and there goes the whistle. Whistle's usually pretty active in the first chuck or so because everybody's kind of, you know, a little tight and trying to feel each other out there. And I've never seen this statistically, but here's a look at that foul. Adolfo came around the back, and then he kind of jumped on the line there. But I think we're going to take a walk to the north end on this one.
Well, you really got to see what Julian Mannix did off the play there. He stuck with Adolfo. He didn't chase after the ball. He stuck with Adolfo, took him out, made it so Adolfo didn't have any time. You give a guy like Adolfo a half second, he turns it into as much time as he wants. Julian gave him no time, able to apply pressure. Adolfo wasn't able to do his play. was able to draw the foul, Julian was, and now we got a penalty four here in favor of the Alegria team. Nice play there by Julian.
All right, Mannix Brothers, of course, they're the premier name of polo in Canada. Have you ever played in Canada?
I have. I played in Calgary when I was younger. It was very nice. Actually, it was at the Mannix's place. It was a beautiful place. One of the nicest fields I've ever seen in my life.
And one of the great names in polo, as is the name Orthwine there. We'll let you brag about that later on.
We'll see. I don't know. We're not up there with the Mannix's, but, you know, it's nice. These Mannix's are tough. They're very strong players, very tough.
The Orthwine goes way, way back in polo history. We'll get to that after we take a look at this penalty shot. Wind up. There's the shot. Del Rio gets deflected right in front and flips out to the outside, and we'll have another safety. Just for people that are watching that don't know what happened there, explain to them about how the defender, there you can see it on the replay, how he got a good stick on that.
Well, the defender was able to get it. You see Adolfo there, great eye work, able to keep it from going in the goal, but when it came off his mallet, it went over the end line, over his own end line, therefore it results in a safety, which is basically a penalty four, except for it's parallel to where the ball went out of play. It's still 60 yards away, still a defended goal, so we're going to do this all over again. Here we go.
And a great day, Orthwine. Now, how many people have played over the last 30 years of this sport? Probably more than a handful, right?
I don't know if I count that high. There's quite a bit of Orthwines that I played. A few years ago, we had a tournament for my grandfather's 80th birthday. We fielded six teams, all four-man teams, all Orthwines.
Amazing. They're the Pierrises of North America. There's the penalty shot, again, deflected in the front. The goalpost goes down, and the whistle sounds, and they're going to call that a goal. So, great play. That's going to be it. We have played one. The score is 2-1 in favor of Alegria. We'll be right back. Go, El Hampton. Go. We are back and ready to go. The players are on fresh horses. An exciting first chucker there with Red taking full advantage of a couple of good opportunities. They lead the yellow team 2-1. Adolfo with the ball now as he's on the far side of the field. Adolfo working it hard. This guy has tremendous horses. He can outdance, outperform, outturn, outrun anybody out there with most of the horses he brings to the game. Robert Janavis gets a stick on it. Now it gets lost, trying to get the pick up is Red. Ball gets laid downfield. Alegria now on offense. Here comes Fred Mannix. Mannix is loose out front. He's got a horse length on the defender. Mannix on the bounce, and he can't connect. It may roll legs on its own. It's a little wide. No, it's in there. Fred Mannix with a super power run. That's the kind of polo I saw him playing down in Argentina, Robert. He can really turn it on when he wants to.
You know, we talk about Adolfo and how much talent he has, but I tell you, Freddie Mannix, he's got just as much talent with the ball. He's incredible with the ball. And you saw here, Mariano, just a quick pass out to, that was Julian, his younger brother. Great goal by Julian, who's also got the same genes, I guess. You know, he's got a great talent as well. So, you know, you saw the teamwork there. Great play.
All right, back to the throw-in now. 3-1. Red with a two-goal lead, and we've got a whistle right out of the throw-in. So we'll pick up the ball, and it looks like we're going to move the territory. We got the markers out there, Robert. They're in midfield, and then you got three in front of each goalpost.
Penalty four here is from 60 yards out. It's a defended goal. Penalty three is from 40. It is defended, but a player cannot come out until the ball is struck. So one player will come out and defend it as the ball is struck and try and get it out of the air. And penalty two is from 30 yards, and it is undefended. Here's a penalty four. You'll see the guys line up 30 yards away, and all four players on the opposing team are able to defend.
You ever get hit by the ball when you're standing there with one of those Tommy Biddle rockets coming at you?
I'm actually currently playing with Tommy Biddle. I got a couple bruises on my back. He's hit me some passes that didn't get in front of me. That kind of came right to the back of me and got a couple marks.
Yeah, that guy can. That's like a cruise missile coming out there. That guy can hit him 120 miles an hour. I think he's the fastest hitter in the game today.
Yeah, he crushes it. He plays like he's playing with a toothpick. He's a beast.
All right, look at Adolfo. He's at 60 yards up in the air between the post, and he's got a goal. Adolfo from the penalty line, and he closes the gap there within one. It's Alegria 3 and Valiente 2. Just under 6 minutes now in the second period. Again, we'll come back to the middle. We'll switch directions, get everybody going opposite ways. Umpire waits for everybody to line up, puts the ball right back in play right away. Mannix with a quick hit under the neck of the pony. Now he's lost it on his second attempt. Here's Pelon Sterling. David Sterling with a nice backhander looking for open space. Beautiful layup shot. It's Alejo. Alejo Taranco. Alejo has laid it up in front, and he's on the money. How many games are won and lost in the throw-in, Robert?
You got to really stay with your man there. You saw Freddie, he had the ball coming out, and he turned the other direction, left Alejo wide open. Alejo's able to make a nice run, undefended, just stroke it in the goal like he's sticking balling. You got to really stay with your man. There's a little bit of lack of discipline on the Alegria team, and this Valiente squad will burn you all day for one mistake.
And that definitely was costly error there at the throw-in. So now we are tied with about 4:40 left in the second period here. Out of the throw-in, Alegria. Mariano Aguirre with the next shot. A little bit short as it gets deflected. He picks up his own shot. Mariano taking it down to the corner. He's a little bit wide of the goalpost. Can he hit a next shot there? He's going to go for it. Slide it right along the back line, and he's a little bit wide to the left. That guy's a threat inside of 60 anywhere. It doesn't make a difference if it's 50 yards to the left or not.
One of the most complete players in the game. He's got all the shots. Knows where to be. He'll start sinking those next chucker and everything as this play, as this game goes on. He'll start sinking those, and you'll see the goals come in.
All right. Valiente 2 with a knock-in now. This is Pelon Sterling in the corner. Pelon in traffic. He's going to wait to find somebody open in front. Now he slapped it down. It'll roll to midfield, but Alegria will be there to cut it out to take it back the other way. Aguirre with another back shot going the other way. Mannix looking for riding room. He's ahead of the defender. He's got room to stick it there if he can. Two yellow jerseys chasing him down. They both can't take him out, though. One guy's got to leave way to the other. Now they've lost the balls. It comes to the boards. Sterling on the takeaway. Aguirre with a back shot to keep it back in play toward their goal. Maddox, Julian trying to go for the goal right out there. Boy, that was a tough play. When you're that close to that back line, those goalposts look like they're about 2 yards apart.
All you really can do is just go for it. I mean, you don't really want to do anything else. You don't want to try and turn it back. You might foul. You just got to put it in or out. If you put it in, everybody gets you a pat on the back. If you put it out, you got to go back to defense.
And that means hamburgers tonight instead of steak, right?
That's right.
All right, here's Adolfo now. Yellow having a hard time getting this ball to midfield in this period. Adolfo. Now Adolfo, a little bit of control work. Defender comes in. It's Mariano Aguirre on the takeaway. And Yellow has lost the ball again. Adolfo back in hot pursuit. He'll try to track this down inside of 40 yards. There's the angled shot cut out of there, going the other way. Picked up now by Pallone Sterling. Sterling on the boards. Now he's lost it. Back shot going the other way. Adolfo strolling back to the ball now. He'll pop one up in the air over everybody's heads and put it back up against the boards again. On the boards, they're trying to get it down this way. They have not been down here for about 2 minutes of play, and we're down to about 2:15 left in the period. Finally, it crosses midfield. Alejo checks down. Under the pony, it gets kicked away. Look at Pallone. He's going to go for the goal. Adolfo's there for the insurance. It shorts up, and he's got the goal. Wow. Now, that's teamwork right there. There's your best player on the field way out in front, away from the play, like what a number one would look like. And look at what Pallone does. He sees him out front there.
All these guys can hit perfect passes. I mean, you see Alejo with the ball. You see Pallone with the ball. Adolfo, they can hit passes to each other. Looks like we're going to have a quick throw-in out here, too. It's all the Valiente teams out there, but none of the Alegria. This looks like it could be a breakaway.
All right, there's the throw-in. Red decided to go change horses. That's a costly error because it's Adolfo loose with the ball. There's nobody within 50 yards of him. He takes a shot on goal. It's a little short. He keeps it on the field. Now it gets turned around. Pallone there to back him up. And a lucky break for Alegria. They might be able to dig it out of there. It goes against the boards on the southwest corner. Alejo. Alejo looking for room. He can't get it out. Now it's David Sterling. Sterling working along the back line. Ball taken away. Left in front. There's Adolfo with a walk in the park. One more tap, and he's got the goal. Well, that whole play was crazy. They had a chance. They had like 4-on-1 there at the throw-in, and then Adolfo missed that first opportunity, but he finished it off here really well.
You know, it all started, Alegria, with a little miscommunication. All four players went to go change horses at the same time. You can't do that. You got to know when your teammates are changing, so you have three of the guys at least out there to defend. A couple mental mistakes, and Alegria finds themselves down 2 goals. After a lot of work, they should be up by 2, but they're down by 2. A couple mental mistakes there at the end of the chucker.
2 chuckers down. We've got 4 to go. Stay with us. It's the quarterfinals of the USPA Piaget Gold Cup. Go, Alejandro. Welcome back to our coverage here. The quarterfinal match today between Alegria and Valiente. No clear favorite in the early going, Robert. We're 5-3 here in favor of Valiente. They kind of caught fire there in the last couple minutes of the second.
You know, we played 15 minutes here, and I'd say about 13 of those minutes, Alegria has played lights out, disciplined. They've made the correct pass, has done everything. And those 2 minutes of mistakes, Adolfo, he burns you, makes you pay. And that's what's happening.
They got to keep a lid on that guy. And Robert Janavis, the captain of this Valiente 2 team, but he's under the gun because his father won this morning against Lechuza Caracas. So there's one Valiente team that's already qualified for the semifinals of the USPA Gold Cup. Here's Mariano Aguirre out of the throw-in to start the third. Nice shot downfield. Adolfo is there. He seems to be everywhere sometimes. Beautiful angled tail shot coming out there at about 45 degrees. Back in the corner, again, head-to-head, and Adolfo wins it as he powers it back downfield. Attempt on the pickup, cut away by Red. Now over toward the far boards. Off of the boards now, there's a nice pickup for Yellow. Beautiful layup shot right down in front. Robert Janavis can't get a handle on it. Gets cut out of there by Red again. Alegria trying to tighten up the defense in this chucker. They don't want to get too deep in the water this early in the game. On the boards, near side back shot by Mannix. Aguirre trying to follow it up, and it kicks out to the left. There's Adolfo. Adolfo, little punch shot, push and a flip, and it's in there. The guy plays it back, plays it front. That shot, there were 8 guys coming across the field at us, and he just came out of nowhere, Robert.
Comes out of nowhere, and he's all alone. You got to have some pressure on him. I mean, he's coming from the back. You see his teammate, Palon Sterling, fellow 10-goal player. He's tough to defend in his own right. And you just see Adolfo pop out in the front. Everybody's looking at Palon Sterling. Adolfo's all alone. He's never going to miss this. I mean, you got to have a body with him. You got to have a guy sitting with him off the play.
All right, back in play now. We've switched directions. Red will be going to your left if they can get the ball. Fred Mannix is just about to do that. There's his first shot down in the corner. Alejo in pursuit on defense. Fred's going to go for it from there, but he is way wide to the outside. That'll be off the field and a turnover. One thing you don't want to do, you're a little bit under the gun because you're trailing, but you don't want to take those wide, long desperation shots.
A lot of time. We're still very, very early in this game. And Alegria has been playing very well for the most part. They just need to get back to the way they were playing in the first and early parts of the second chucker, and back to the disciplined way of guarding Adolfo and shutting him down.
All right, Adolfo with a knock-in. Takes his second shot, puts it up by the near boards. Pilon will give way to Mannix. Mannix doesn't get the shot away that he wants. Sterling checks up on the boards with him. Del Rio putting the pressure on him. Mariano with the interception. Mariano now loose in front. Mariano switches to the near side. He'll get pushed into play, but look at Mariano take control as he pushes him right back and picks it up. Pallone's trying to catch him. Mariano, go! Wow! That's why that guy is such a disciplined veteran. He never loses sight of anything out there as far as defenders, where the ball is, where the goalposts are. Look at him coming to goal here.
Awesome. Silver Fox, one of the best players of all time. I mean, he's actually left-handed. You see all players using their right hand with the holding the mallet. That's why he's able to have such ability on the left side, though. He's a left-handed player. He's got a great eye there. Able to read the play, pick it up here on the boards, take it all the way into the goal, no problem. Awesome play by Aguirre.
All right, that brings him back to life here. We're down to about 4 minutes left in the first half. It is 6-4 in favor of Yellow, Valiente 2. Adolfo with the ball. He's got one man to beat. He's going to go for a 95-yard bomb from the outside. It's rolling to goal, and he got it. All right, I take back what I said 2 minutes ago. He can do that.
When you're up, you're a little more comfortable. Those shots kind of go in when you're up. But when you're down, you know, they go a couple feet wide. When you're up, they kind of find their way in the goal. They get eyes. And when you're Adolfo, they always have eyes. They always find the goal when you're Adolfo.
All right, Adolfo Cambiaso bringing him back to life and widening the gap once again. 3:40 left in the first half. It's 7-4 in favor of Valiente 2. They're looking for a chance to get to the semifinals of the Gold Cup. Aguirre backs it up the other way. There's Pilon. Pilon is called off. Adolfo pushes it forward, then sends Pilon the pass. They work so good as a 1-2. High bouncer, though. He couldn't connect on it. Now it's left down in front. Mannix is in there to follow it up. They clear it out in front of that goal mouth to send it to the near boards. Mannix still making the turn now to come back to the north end. Aguirre checks down on it. He's overridden the play, and it's Adolfo in the back. Adolfo from way outside on the outside. He's got his approach shot. Now here comes the finisher. Nobody's on him. Angle to the right. The shot. It's outside. Wide. Robert, you've been saying this all game. They got to keep a lid on that guy.
Alegria got a big break there. You see Aguirre pushing the line as the play develops. You see him pushing the line thinking he has it. So he leaves the play right here. And you got to know, it's only a foul if the referee blows his whistle. So you got to keep playing. They got a big, great, big break with Adolfo missing this goal. He doesn't miss these very often. He's put a lot in already today. Normally he'll put this in. Just wide, though. Just off the post and wide.
It's a great argument against appealing, because sometimes if you're checking down and you got your mallet in the air, the guy's got two steps on you and you're in trouble.
You're off the field. You got to keep your feet, your mallet. You got to be ready on the field all the time until the whistle blows.
All right, there's Aguirre with a back shot for Alegria. It goes against the boards. Alejo tries to dig it off of there. Alejo with a nice job in heavy traffic. Alejo now next it across field. There's Adolfo. He's going to go for the next shot. This one's up in the air. Pop shot. And it's in. What a play, Adolfo Cambiasso. The guy is, I hate to use the term loose cannon because sometimes that has a negative connotation, but when he's loose, he's firing a cannon at that goal.
I mean, he's the satellite-directed cannon is what he is. He doesn't miss. I mean, this guy misses the easy tapping before. He goes right back, gets the ball back, and he puts an incredible neck shot. And look at this shot. I mean, he's almost hitting it backwards. Can't hook that. Look, he does hit it backwards. He hits the old Mexican back shot through the goal is what they call that one. Hitting it with that back angle right through the goal. Incredible.
No way to defend that. Now, 8-4, they have doubled it up as we're back in play with less than a minute 20 to go. Alegria. From the back, it's Del Rio. Del Rio puts one down in front, but it goes way wide to the outside on the deflection. There's Pilon now. Pilon turning, and his horse is still moving. It's got legs. He's left it by the boards. Mannix is there. He can't get his stick on it. Alejo lays it down in front. Nobody there. Red will take it away. He's going to make a turn with it here. They're burning up the clock now. Less than a minute left in the half. Looking over the field. He's not in a hurry. He's asked to leave it by Mannix. Mannix lays the lumber into this one as he soars down to the corner. That's probably going to hit the boards and end the period. They're trying to dig it off the boards before that 30-second warning horn, because that would end the period. Digging it out of there. Coming around the left. There's the warning horn. They've got 30 seconds to go. We'll play it out till the ball goes dead or off the field. Aguirre trying to get in front of Adolfo. Scramble for it at the front. And Del Rio shot goes wide and off the field, no good. We'll end the first half of the Gold Cup, 8-4 in favor of Valiente 2. Let's take a halftime break. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Our coverage here from the International Polo Club of Palm Beach. This is the USPA PGA Gold Cup quarterfinals. The winner moving on to the semifinals. And next week, we'll be here to bring you the finals of this year's Gold Cup from the USPA. Ron Allen along with Robert Orthwine. And Robert, what do you think they talked about at halftime here? Rhett did pretty well for a couple chuckers, but now they're in a little trouble.
Well, I'm sure the Red team, they talked a little bit about getting all their pieces working together. You know, they got to work in clockwork. Valiente team, I think they just said, let's keep playing polo like we've been playing. Keep working for Adolfo. That's really all you got to do. There's not much strategy. Just get Adolfo the ball, or he'll find it, work it, work his way to goal. I'll agree. They, you know, it's the old adage, you can't stop them. You just only hope to contain them. They got to contain them. They really got to hold them to one or two goals in this next half to climb back into this game. It's a lot easier said than done, though.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. The guy is so well-mounted. He's got horses with talent. He's got horses with speed. He's a guy that obviously has it all top to bottom, and that obviously could make a big difference here when we get to the end of this game. We got three chuckers to go. We'll see what happens. The guy we're talking about has the ball right now. This is Adolfo with the knock-in. Adolfo takes his second shot. Tapping it in the air a little bit on the other side. Now he slows down. Mannix on the takeaway, backs it up right in front of the IPC lodge there. But it takes a bad hop and goes off the field. So when that happens, we'll line everybody up and we'll give them the ball back. On a throw-in, a 50-50 chance that somebody's going to win it or lose it, either way. So there it goes out the back door. Adolfo, nice reach on the near side, the left side of the pony. Now he checks down, trying to get away from the defender. He's got no one to pass to, so he's going to hold it at the back for a while. Now he gets underneath it, and he pops a big one in the air, way wide to the outside on the right. It looks like it's going to stay on the field. And Alegria is going to try to get it to the corner and get it out of there, but it's taken away again by Valiente 2. Adolfo's with it. Adolfo working it down in front. He's in close where he can shoot on goal, and he does, and he scores. Adolfo Cambiaso, they're not listening to you today, Robert.
You know, I'm sure they're hearing it, but it's tough to do. You see, they talk a lot about the speed and the stuff of the horses, but with Adolfo, it's really the stop. I mean, so much handle. You see him just hit the brakes, let the guy fly by, carry it behind him. Now he's got a wide open shot from about 10 yards away. How do you defend that? You don't defend it. He puts it in the goal. Simple as could be.
Yeah, and a tough break for Freddie Mannix, because when you're in that position on defense, really there's nothing you can do, and it's so frustrating from that standpoint. All right, we're back in action here. Out to the outside. Valiente, too, with the lead and the ball. Pelon at the back of the pack. Now he's lost it. There's Adolfo trying to come in on a follow-up, but a great takeaway for Alegria. Miss hit on the ball. Adolfo. Turn around the other way. Jernot was a little hit there to take it away, but Allegri is going to be on it by the boards. Mannix just taking his time. Mannix leaves it behind for Mariano. Now they leave it again. Del Rio trying to find room for it, but Adolfo says, thank you very much, goes for the next shot on the near side. This guy is nonstop. Unbelievable. I mean, I don't even know how that happened. The guy, again, out of nowhere and ends up with the next shot when the other two guys are trying to figure out who's going to take it and how they're going to clear it out in front of the goal mound.
It looked like Garcia Del Rio kind of hit Adolfo there with a little bit of not the cleanest hit, trying to clear him out of the way, kind of get Adolfo a little upset. So he took the ball right away, did a nice near side next shot right in the goal. And another point there for Valiente.
All right, we're on the run now as Valiente 2 goes up by 6 goals, 10-4 here. 4:30 to go in the fourth. Aguirre by the far boards. There's Adolfo going in front. Here's a nearside backhander, but the whistle goes, and that'll stop the clock here. We played quite a bit without had a lot of whistles there in the early going of the game, but they got kind of quiet the last couple chuckers.
Well, you know, the players, they find the rhythm. They understand what the referee's going to call. Each ref, you know, they all do a great job, all the refs they meet and everything like that. But all refs are different. Some of them are, you know, call the game a little tighter, some a little loose. You know, so the players have to feel out how the ref pairings work, and players have figured it out, and so we've had a little more open game here.
Adolfo, he takes a big swat downfield. Look at that ball cross midfield. Wide open shot. This is Alejo, all alone in front. One, two, three, go! Wow, that was a two-man play there. Rodolfo taking it to get the play started, then he's powered the ball over everybody's head, and Alejo was wide open here to just take this in.
Great pass there by Rodolfo. Alejo just walking it in. Nobody there guarding him. Able to just take as much time as he wanted and strokes it in. Great goal. Garcia Del Rio can do nothing but watch. And that's really been the story here, especially since midway through the second chucker.
Alejo Taranco is actually a cousin of Pilon Sterling, the teammate number three yellow on this Valiente 2 team here. Now with their eyes wide open with a chance, look at this. Adolfo comes in, tries the near side. He gets hooked. Legal play. Either side of the horse, as long as you're directly behind him or beside him. Aguirre now. Mariano tries to push it to midfield. Fred Mannix is there. Mannix slowing it down. He'll try to maybe turn or walk it away from this player, but they can't walk the ball for too long. He's going to have to hit away here. Now he's lost it. Gernavis comes in on defense. On the boards, it's Mannix. Mannix now gets it away about 10 yards inside the boards. Now it clears to the outside. There's Adolfo. Adolfo lays one downfield. Looking for Pilon. Pilon checks down, waiting for Mannix's back shot, and he'll try to pick that off if he can. Pilon waits for it to bounce off the boards. Now he'll come right behind the defenders and go the other way. There's nobody on him. Pilon has Adolfo clearing the way. Look at Gernavis take the man out of there. Now Pilon's going to go for a goal from out there, but it's a big gamble and a wide shot. You got a 6-goal lead. Why not, right?
That's right. You know, like you said earlier, when you're up the balls, they have eyes and they find the goal. But you saw Pilon there, his stick broke. He went over and got a new stick. So maybe a little bit of a ringer on that mallet head. And it's a little bit wide, but good effort there. You got to put it on goal. Great. That's the play.
All right, now the umpires have called official timeout. We're talking in the first half about Orthwine family. Who are the active players in your family now besides you and Stevie?
Well, Stevie and I play. My father, he plays with two fake hips and two fake knees, but he's been the only one in our family that's been able to take home a trophy this season. He won the 12 goal over there at Gulfstream.
How does he get through the airport with all that metal?
Oh, man. He gives him fits. He just has a special pass. You know, he's in the Hall of Fame now, so they gave him a special pass, a polo player pass through the security gate.
All right, we're back in action here. Red under the gun. They have got to generate some offense here in the upcoming minutes. Next shot, not where he wanted it to be, and guess what? It's the stick of Adolfo that jumps out in front. Mannix trying to catch him. Adolfo scoots it toward goal. Mannix on the defense, but he's too late. It's a goal again. Adolfo Cambiasso racking him up like no tomorrow. This guy really is on fire, this chart.
You know, a few years ago, Adolfo played, and they had, with Julio Arellano and Hilario Joa, they dominated. They won everything. The following year, they came back, and they didn't have quite as strong a team. He played with a little bit of a different team with Hilario and Nachi Duplessis. They didn't do so well. People were saying Adolfo maybe slipped from his pedestal as the top player in the world, but today we are seeing no evidence of that.
He's back, as they say. All right, here we go. Valiente. Cut away. That's over to Taranco on the boards. Alejo Taranco is there. Now he's asked to leave it by Adolfo. Adolfo trying to dig it out of there. He's got a player right in front of him. Nobody wants to clear out. Julian was in a bad spot there. I think the last thing he wanted was a ball in the face.
Exactly. Someone put his hands up. Hey, let me get out of the way here. And that's kind of what it's been going for Alegria. They just want to get out of the way. They're getting hurt here by Adolfo. You see a little stick work on the boards, trying to drag it out. Adolfo puts it under Julian's belly there, so he had the line, but we'll see what they call. I think it's going to go against Alegria, but we'll see what the refs call here. Yep, it looks like it's going to go in favor of Valiente. Is Julian trying to get out of the way, but he was sort of stuck there, and there's really nothing he could do. I mean, Adolfo, put it in a place where Julian didn't want to foul, but he was fouling and came across the line there, and we're going to get another Valiente penalty shot.
All right, Valiente up 12-4 now. We're down to the final minute of the fourth period. We've got two to go after this, but definitely Valiente looking forward to advancing to the semifinals later in the week this week. And as we said before, make sure you're with us next week when we will bring you the finals of the second leg of the American Triple Crown, which is the USPA Gold Cup. After that, we'll move forward and work our way through the month of April and then be here for the U.S. Open Championship, which is the premier polo event in the United States every year. This is Adolfo. He's taking a big wide circle to take the penalty shot, 60 yards out underneath it. It's a skyrocket, 20, 30 yards in the air, and he's on the money. He had a little trouble earlier in the season hitting those penalty shots, but it looks like he's found the hand-eye coordination now. Look at this one.
Well, he definitely has hand-eye coordination. It's exactly how I hit my penalty fours, but then the sun comes up and I have to wake up out of bed. I mean, perfect. Perfect. The dream of a shot there. Great execution by Adolfo. Just showing why he's the best player in the world. I mean, really terrific.
All right, so the blowout now underway, 13-4. Robert Jernavis knocks it loose out of the throw-in. The warning horn is sounded. Mannix is there with a back shot. It gets deflected. Scramble for the ball. Player goes in front as he tries to hit away, and they're going to say Alejo was in the path of the right-of-way there. Let's talk a little bit about that rule. A lot of people watch it, and they feel like they're watching hockey because there's a red line and the blue line and everything else. We're basically talking about a line of the ball here and how the player has a right-of-way to be able to hit it.
Right. It's basically every time the ball is hit in the direction that the ball is going, an imaginary line is created, and it's a possession line, basically. To gain possession of that line, a player either has to come in parallel to it and play on the left side, or they have to bump that player that holds possession over the line and take it. So every time the ball is hit, it creates a line, and the players have to respect that line. They can't come across it. It's just like the line driving in cars and things like that. You can't just come 90 degrees into the road.
Like I-95 at 5 o'clock in the afternoon around here?
Exactly. Sometimes people do that, but you know, they get tickets, and here we have a ticket against the Valiente squad.
And of course, the other thing we're talking about is the right-of-way, which is that distance between, the distance between your mallet and the end of the mallet. There's a kind of a lane there that you have to stay out of.
Yeah, the rule book has it as two mallet lengths, because a lot of these guys can stretch out so far, they can stretch out off their horse about the distance of a mallet, so it's two mallet lengths is how long that line has to extend exactly.
All right, here's Aguirre, stride and easy. Time running out of the fourth. They need this one. It's a hard line drive, but he's a little wide to the outside. That's going to be no good. That will play four. We're 13-4 in favor of Valiente 2. It's the Gold Cup from the International Polo Club, Palm Beach, and we'll be right back. Welcome back. Chukka number five about to get underway here. A major fourth period here for this yellow team. Robert, they put them on notice. We're taking no prisoners from here on out.
Yeah, you know, Adolfo and this Valiente team really just took control in that fourth chucker. problem. If Alegria is going to do anything, they really got to have an epic chucker here in this fifth. They really got a lot of work cut out for them.
All right, here they are with the ball. This team has controlled this ball all afternoon. This is Malone Sterling. And Maddox going for a nearside backhander back toward that goal, but Adolfo's in there to try to put a nearside swat on it to get it out. Now it's Pilon again. Pilon by the boards. Adolfo coming back in to help him out there on the other side. Alejo is following him up as well. Look at Pilon. He's worked a full circle now, and he's still got the ball. Now it gets taken away by Alegria. Alejo. And Alejo goes back, and he goes up, and now he's waving to the crowd. What? Me, man, what happened?
A little bit of a delayed whistle there, but, you know, that's the way I saw it. Julian kind of took the ball under his neck, and he was right on it, and Leo kind of came right across and crossed that line that we were speaking about earlier. And, yeah, you'll see it here as this replay comes through. Julian able to put the pressure on Sterling. Gets the loose ball. He's got it. Puts it under his neck. Now he's coming down the line. And there you see, perfect. You see Alejo coming, not quite 90 degrees, but coming in at a severe enough angle where he interfered with the possession that Julian had on the ball. And now we got a foul in favor of the Alegria team as they try to climb back into this match.
All right, they needed the break. Hopefully they can cut a couple more of those because they'll need it. We're early minutes here, early seconds actually, of this fifth period. They have not scored for quite a while here. In fact, we ended the half. They had only had 4 points on the board, so let's see what they can do here. Mannix, he drills that one. It's beautiful. Big, hard ball, but I think he was trying to compensate for the wind there. He kind of overshot it toward the left, and the wind really never sailed it back to correct it for him.
It was well hit, but, you know, it's tough. When things are going the way they are for Alegria today, that's the way they're going. They're just going inches wide, and tough break there, but they got to come back here and get back to work defensively.
All right, they could hold them in their own end zone early in this game. Let's see if they can keep that up on defense now. Yellow with the ball. Adolfo leaves it behind. Look at this. Adolfo breaks out with the pony, but he can't keep it. Aguirre, beautiful wind up and connecting on the back shot. Freddie Mannix's a short shot. He can't find his man, and guess what? It's Pilon going for goal. There's nobody down there. And tough break on that one. I don't think he looked up quick enough there. He kind of looked up and glanced and just tried to fire, but it's a good practice shot at this stage.
Exactly. That's kind of what's going on here a little bit. You know, everything's working so well for the Valiente team. They're shooting from way out, trying to get a little more confidence. It looks like they're going to be heading into the semifinals, but still a lot of time left. See if Alegria can get something going.
All right. Here's Alegria. Robert Jernovis on the takeaway. Nice pick by Robert. Robert, good backhander to clear it out of traffic. Pilon has to give way now. Julian Mannix. Julian, he's going to hold it till his man can get open. Julian, stroking easy downfield, trying to find somebody open in front. Mariano Aguirre on it. Aguirre trying to get out of traffic now. Aguirre still trying to make a left-hand turn now as he's running out of real estate. There he goes with the next shot toward goal. Can he catch it one more time on the shot, under the pony, and off the field? Now bad luck is playing a role in this red team.
Yeah, there's, you know, a lot of work here. It's heartbreaking to watch. They're doing a lot of work. It was a nice pickup by Julian Mannix. He looked up, held it for a bit, waited for Mariano to get open, hit a nice pass to Mariano. Mariano showing some great stick work here, getting by Pilon Sterling. He's got it here, and ball's bouncing, going at high speeds. It's a tough shot, very tough angle shot. And when things are going right, that sinks, but things aren't going right now for Alegria.
All right, Adolfo hammers one all the way to midfield, and look at this. We've got a breakaway. It's Alejo by himself. Alejo hammers it up in the air. He's misdirected that shot. Mariano was there on the pick. Mariano at the back line. Alejo trying to steal it back away from him. Mariano now waiting for some red shirts to get open in the front as he switches off to the right side to get it centered up. Now he goes for an angled shot. That's a beautiful play. Looking for Fred Mannix. Adolfo charging with a pony to catch him on defense. Mannix puts it over by the near boards and a big hop. Settles just in time for Mannix to hammer it under the neck of the pony. Big rush to it. There's his brother Julian. Julian puts on the brakes. Can he get there in time? He's going for the next shot, but he's run out of, he actually ran out of line there. There's not much he could do except make a desperation swing at that point, Robert.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration setting in. You know, it was a nice pick up there by Freddie Mannix, but his first shot on the ball, he really didn't hit it as cleanly as he liked. And he had a kind of an off-balance pass to his brother there, Julian, not setting him up as well as he would have liked to. And Julian went to the ball, but he's taken out by Adolfo and not able to get a clean shot on goal and goes wide again. Now we got another Valiente knock-in.
All right, this is Adolfo Cambiaso now working it on the knock-in. Aguirre trying to get a near side shot off the left side of the pony there. Now it gets scrambled up, but Mannix gets a good shot to back it out of there. Nice stick work out of the air. Pelon at midfield. Beautiful pickup. Now he's under pressure. Defender comes in. And Jornavis jumps in front, and the umpire says, hold the phone on this. So this might be a break for red here. That'll stop the clock with 2:47 left in the fifth. We'll have another period to go after this. The winner goes on, and we've got two qualifiers so far for the semifinals. The Valiente team today, it might be a little bit premature to say that, but I really don't think so. And then, of course, the father of Robert Jornavis is Bob Jornavis. His team winning this morning in overtime against La Chuza Caracas. So a one-goal victory there allows Valiente to move forward as well. So we're going to have two Valiente teams into the semifinals. Bob Jornavis won the C.V. Whitney, the first 26th goal in the American Triple Crown Series a couple of weeks ago. So definitely a Valiente season here in South Florida this year. We got a penalty shot in midfield coming up. Players will pair off 1-1. Clock is stopped until he swings at the ball. Del Rio taking his time, looking over the field, see if there's anybody open. Now he's just going to dribble it and try to keep it going forward as much as he can. He's in a little bit of traffic. Swing and a miss. He gets hooked. No good. Angled shot. Fred Mannix nails one to go. And more bad luck. Mannix had all day. A little bit of an angle, but again, just bad luck, Robert.
You know, when it came off his mouth, I thought it was going right through the goal mouth. It looked like it took a bounce right off the divot and kicked just inches wide there. That's just really the story of the day for Alegria. Tough break. Nice shot by Freddie, but terrible bounce.
All right. Here's the pickup. We're down to 2 minutes left in this period. It's Freddie Mannix just outside of midfield there as he backs it up toward those far boards. There is Pelon. Pelon pops one up in the air. Adolfo waiting for it to settle right in front of the lodge. Adolfo is on it. Adolfo taking his time. Yellow team in no hurry here. They don't have to generate a lot of goals, but there goes a whistle. That'll stop the clock at a minute 42. 13-4. Valiente with a major lead here. We're going to pick this ball up, and we're going to chew up some real estate and bring it probably down to the 60-yard line, you think? Look at the replay.
It was, you know, it was an aggressive effort there by Julian Mannix. So, you know, they really got to give him, they really got to award Adolfo a strong penalty here because, you see, Julian coming in aggressively, kind of reaches right across Adolfo's horse to make that hook, and Adolfo's not very happy about it. But
well, he lost his mouth there. It was a pretty good soccer move, didn't you think?
A little bit of one of those dives, you know, but still a foul nonetheless. You know, you got to always say whenever the referee blows his whistle, it's a foul, so it's a foul. Like you were saying earlier about the Valiente 1 team going to the semifinals, this Valiente 2 team is the one that faced off against them in the C.B. Whitney final, so it's no surprise that this Valiente team has played so strongly today. Could see the same finals again in this Gold Cup.
Yeah, that team first showed up here about 3 years ago, and you know how it is. You're making your first perusal into this effort, and there's a lot to learn. It's not like, you know, you're coming from Omaha and you had a 12-goal team. This is a very different kind of game here.
These are international superstars, the best players in the world, best horses in the world. You know, you really got to build from the ground up. You got to have the horses, you got to have the players, you got to have the organization, the coaches, the trainers, the grooms, everything. To win at this level, you can't be missing one piece of tape. I mean, everything needs to be there.
All right, the penalty shot by Adolfo goes wide to the left, so we'll turn it over, and there you can see it on the replay. It sails up in the air. He certainly had the distance, but he's just a little bit to the left-hand side. Aguirre with the knock-in, takes his second shot. Correction, Del Rio up to Mannix. Mannix on a bad hop, can't get it. Little pop shot by Alejo, and there's Adolfo. He's on it. Look at the pony power on this guy. He'll turn her loose now as he rolls down outside. Mannix can't catch him. He's two lengths behind. Adolfo in and a goal. Adolfo Cambiasso. That's got to be 8 or 9 so far in the game for this guy.
He's an animal. You saw him get a little tricky there on the end. He's doing a little showboating with this strong lead, doing a little tiki-tacky, doing some nice stick work, dribbling it in the air through the goal mouth. That's what this guy can do. I mean, he's just, what an athlete. Look at this on the replay here. Freddie in pursuit. Adolfo knows he has the time. Picks it up. Tap. Teak. Moon. Right through the goal mouth. Just showing off.
Saw you do that last week in the other game you played.
Yeah, you know, I do that from time to time, but not quite so pretty. I do it on accident if I do it.
All right. There goes Adolfo off to get a fresh pony. We have played 5-14-4. Valiente 2 on their way to the semifinals. We'll be back with the last chucker. It is 14-4 in favor of Valiente 2 as they really turned up the heat in the fourth period, and they were strolling in the park in the fifth, and Robert, what's that saying about it's not over till the fat lady sings? I think they're going to find her right now.
I heard her warming up out back. I mean, she's about ready to come on. This is a pretty tough task here for the Alegria team, down by 10 going into the final chucker play here.
Well, this has been an amazing tournament, too. There have been a lot of great games. We had rain a week ago, which got everybody backed up, and that creates a horse situation because you know how that is. You're riding your horses. You're trying to get them to peak for that one particular game, and then all of a sudden everybody gets thrown off because the rain throws the schedule off.
You know, it's all about the horses. I mean, the horses are such a large part of the game, the conditioning of the horses and everything. You know, today the Alegria team is just a little flatter than the Valiente squad, and it really, really, those little minute details make such a big difference when it comes to game day, as you're seeing.
Yeah, I agree. You've got a situation there where you can do the best you can, and you've got to make a lot of adjustments along the way. 14-4, we've got 7 minutes and 30 seconds of high goal polo left out of the throw-in. It's Robert Jernavis. He nails the first one to go. Picks it up on a bouncer way outside of the reach. Robert Jernavis is there. Robert coming in for the finisher. The shot, the goal, he's got it. Good job for the... he's still in college. Is that amazing? I had no idea until a couple weeks ago. He's only 19.
Oh, he's going to develop into a real nice player here. Nice pickup out on the throw-in. You know, I guess the Alegria team just doing a little miscommunication on who's supposed to mark him, and he just pops it out of the throw-in pretending like he's Adolfo, takes it straight to the hoop, and puts it in for the score. Great goal. He'll be a real nice player here eventually.
Yeah, and he's a good writer. I mean, the one thing that he did do is come to the game with good writing skills, and it made a big difference just with his past experience. All right, Alegria with the ball. See if they can get something on the board here these final few minutes of the match. Now leaves it behind. Del Rio slaps it toward goal. Mannix, and that's no good. The bad luck continues. 6:25 left in the game. It's 15-4 now in favor of Valiente 2. Turnover will come back to yellow. Adolfo. Man, this guy can hit a big ball. Look at that one. That's 120 yards, and it's still going. Big reach out of the saddle. We can't get it. Aguirre. Mariano. This guy probably has 20 gold cups in his home. He has won this tournament so many times with the great White Birch team of the 80s and 90s here at South Florida. Up against the boards on the near side, it's Valiente 2 with the ball. Sterling still working it. Look at this guy. Off the field, back on the field again, still working it. Hammers the ball on downfield. This is going to bounce toward the midfield marker. Look at Jernavis reach out on the near side and pick that up. Mannix is after him. Jernavis, can he score two back-to-back? Jernavis still running a goal. Mannix says, no, I don't think so this time, and bumps him out of there, takes the ball, makes a big clockwise turn, and heads it back the other way. Beautiful hammering shot for Mannix as he lays it against the far boards on the other side. And a bad hop. It leaves the field right there and probably jumped into somebody's vichyssoise there on the other side.
A little souvenir here for the kids as the ball skips over the boards. You know, and you see Robert Jernavis heating up here, and that's what this Valiente team's probably going to work on here in this last shutout play, really getting all the players hot for their semifinal game that's going to be coming up here later on in the week.
All right. Well, ball gets lost, turned around by Red now. Red drilling it back down to the midfield marker. 4 minutes left in the game. Alegria working it slow and easy. Not a lot of pressure there. Here he comes now to finish it off. It's rolling. We're going to have to widen the goalpost. I don't know what else we can do. The bad luck just continues against these guys.
It's heartbreaking. You know, look, does all the work here, dribbling it behind. It was Tarenko, Alejo Tarenko. Perfect possession on it. Tarenko comes in at the last second, pushes him. Nice clean bump, and ball skips over the end line, and tough break for Alegria.
All right, shot past midfield now into the zone where they have lost it. Aguirre tails it back the other way now as it crosses the midfield marker one more time. Less than 4 minutes left in the game. Downfield, Jernavis in pursuit on defense. He's got the back shot. It gets deflected, picked off in the end zone. Now he can't hang on to it as Adolfo comes in to try to save it. He's clearing it out right in front of that goal mouth. Adolfo, still on a bounce. He's got it. Adolfo now winds up, gives it full power. This one at midfield. Look at him run for it. Adolfo sets it to the corner. Can he reach it before it goes off the field? He's running full board. Look at the angled shot from the side. Oh, man. That would have been the play of the day. He was charging at that ball. He was going 30 miles an hour when he decided to cut that.
Maybe 40. I mean, just wow. Adolfo here, he's able to run by Freddie Mannix. He's able to run by Mariano Aguirre. Look at him. He's just going flat out. Hits the ball. Doesn't hit as good of approach shot as he likes. But look at this shot on goal. I mean, deep in the corner. Puts it right on goal at such high speeds. I mean, you say he's going 30. I say he's going 40. Over 40. I mean, he's flying. The ball is just inches wide. Great effort.
Yeah, this is a superstar, no doubt about that. 3 minutes left in the game, 15-14, as Valiente continues the domination here against this Red team. You got any favorites for the finals? What do you think?
You know, I really like that Lechuza team. They had a tough loss today against the Valiente 1. I really like that team, but this Adolfo team is going to be tough to beat. This Valiente 2 team is... Man, they're strong. Pelon Sterling able to be a safety net for Adolfo, so he can do whatever he wants. And when Adolfo does what he wants, you see scores like this.
Del Rio hammers it downfield, looking for Julian Mannix. This is Mannix. He'll pick it up about 100 yards out. Mannix needs to center it up a little more to the left. Can he catch it in time? run into the end zone. There's Mannix, puts the angled shot on it. It's rolling to go, and they've waved it wide again. That's three that they have missed in about 4 minutes.
If I had one piece of advice for Allegria here, it's just you got to just shake your head and smile, because these goals, they normally go in for this team, and they're just inches wide, you know. They're just so close. This shot goes right across the goal mouth face, and how it doesn't go in, I don't know. It's just right there. Tough break for Julian Mannix. Nice carry.
On the slow-mo, it looks like it glanced right off the face of the post there on the left-hand side. 2 minutes left now. Valiente getting ready to celebrate their opportunity to go to the semifinals of the USPA Gold Cup this year. Across the back line, striding easy, finisher. Now he's got it. They found it that time. Not too much pressure that time. That's a little easier.
It might be a little bit too late, but you know, nice play here. Freddie Mannix able to put the pressure on. Gets the hook here. Leaves it behind for Garcia Del Rio. Garcia Del Rio takes his breath, which you need to do. When you're going to goal, you got to take your breath, take your time. He does it. He has his time. Tarenko can't do anything. Just a nice little tap. Finally, right through the middle. Don't put it on the side. You know, you need to put it right in the middle. That's what Allegria's team needs to do.
15-5 now. A minute 20 left in the match. Mannix. And he gets turned around over to the far side now. This is Pelon. Pelon on the pickup. Pelon still working it. Aguirre gets the hook. They leave the ball behind. Del Rio fakes the back shot now. He'll turn around the other way. Less than a minute to go. Tick, tick on the clock. Cut shot. Back the other way by Alejo. Del Rio flips up over the top. And a couple of seconds left here as Alejo backs it up. Adolfo is looking for him. Adolfo angles the next shot across field. Too short. The warning horn is sounded. When the ball goes dead, this is going to be the game, and this could be the goal. Tapping. One more. Mariano. And he got the finisher to make it 15-6, the finals. And it's going to be Valiente 2 advancing to the finals. Two teams in, Valiente 1 and Valiente 2. We'll see if they can manage to be here with us next Sunday for the finals of the USPA Gold Cup. More in a minute.
inning now. Just a few moments, we'll have both the winners and the runners up here. And again, next Sunday is the finals of the 2012 United States Polo Association's Piaget Gold Cup. And then the following week, we'll have four Sundays of the United States Polo Association's Open Championship presented by Nespresso. So lots of great polo coming up right here on the Piaget Field at the IPC, the National Polo Club Fondue. Just a few minutes, we'll have the players over, and we'll go ahead with our award ceremony.
Thank you. Happy, representative from Piaget, North America, making award first to Julian Maddox. Next to Freddie Maddox. Freddie Maddox. He's got a chance for Freddie to pop today. First time dad this week. Congratulations to him and his lovely ride. Next to Mariano Argillin. And last but not least, Tomas Garcia del Rio. Now Lauren will make the award to the winning Valiente squad. First two, Robert Canales. Robert, number one, the team captain. On his first full season of high goal competition. Next to Alejo Carrasco, number two of Valiente. The number three, the newest player to be raised to 10 goals in both the United States and Argentina, Phil Sterling. And next to Adolfo Cambiasso. You know, we'd like to also award our four-legged athletes. And giving the award today, the Grand Dame Claude Radowski of the Pauley Institute, who probably is Gatita, played by Adolfo Cambiasso in Shocker number four. Gatita, played by Adolfo Cambiasso. Grand Dame Claude Radowski will make this award. Mia Cambiasso getting into the boat with Pop. And we're getting a customary blanket on the Gatita. You can't get the ball, let's get your horse to carry there. And I'll tell you what, there are so many good horses today, I don't know how these judges could really make that judgment today. There were so many good horses, a lot of work on the part of the judges. Right through April 22nd, we'll dominate our season with the United States Polo Association's Nespresso Open Championship.